Turn our Bibles to the book of Deuteronomy chapter 11, verse 26, 27 and 28. The book of Deuteronomy chapter 11, verse 26, 27 and 28. It goes on like this. Behold, I set before you today a blessing and a curse. The blessing if you obey the commandments of the Lord your God, which I command you today. And the curse if you do not obey the commandments of the Lord your God, but turn aside from the ways for which I command you today, to go after other gods which you have not known. The Bible clearly is speaking today to each one of us, that today God is putting a blessing and a curse. And the blessing is that if you obey the commandments of God, that which God has commanded each one of us. But when we do not obey the commandments of God, the Bible clearly says that the curse of God will come upon us. Hallelujah. Amen. And that is very much important to each one of us. Because God has given us a choice to choose. Hallelujah. Last time when I spoke about the will of God, I said that God will never interfere with your willpower. Because the choice is always given to you and to me. And here the Lord is speaking in Deuteronomy chapter 11, verse 26, 27 and 28. He says that if you obey my command, all the blessings which are mentioned in the Bible from the book of Genesis to the book of Revelation shall be yours. But when you disobey, he says that the curse will come upon you. Hallelujah. And that's what we understand, that when God has created Adam and Eve, he expected them to obey him. Any cost. But down the road we see that the devil entered into the serpent and deceived Eve, and through Eve deception came into the world, and that's how they brought a curse upon the land. Hallelujah. Amen. That's what we see, and that's what God says, that you shall be cursed and the ground shall also be cursed. That's what he says. Why? Because they disobeyed what God has spoken to us. That's why as a Christian we need to always understand that we must always walk in obedience to the word of God. We need to obey the commandment of God. Hallelujah. And that's what God is looking for every brother and sister gathered in this house, whether you're obedient to God or not. If you have to be obedient, it's then when you will see the blessings of God being fulfilled in your life. Many people are not able to see the blessing of God, because they do not walk in obedience, but they walk in disobedience. They try to do things on their own. They try to manipulate things on their own. They try to think whatever they want to do and ask, expect God to bless them. God does not bless in that way. He wants you and me to be obedient. Hallelujah. He wants you and me to be obedient to receive the blessing of God. I always say something, that it is the will and the plan of God for the church to be blessed. It is not the will and the plan of God for the church to be cursed. Hallelujah. It is not the will and the plan of God for the church to run in poverty. Because we do not serve a poor God, but we serve a rich God. The Bible says he being rich became poor, that we poor may be made rich. Hallelujah. And that's where you need to know your God. Clearly the Bible speaks about, my brother, my sister, that's where the Bible says in the book of Isaiah chapter 1, if you read verse 19, the Bible says clearly that if you are obedient and willing, that you will eat the fruit of the land. That's where to receive the blessing of God, the first thing which you and I need to do, we need to obey the voice of God. The Bible clearly says in Isaiah chapter 1 verse 19, he says that if you are obedient and willing, what it said? You shall eat the fruit of the land. Hallelujah. The fruit of the land is given for you and for me. That's why when God created the heaven and the earth, when he created everything, he gave it that they may not work, that they may not struggle, but they may eat the blessing of God. But down the road, they need to wake up by listening to the devil. Hallelujah. And that's where the devil will always make you ignorant of the word of God. And that's where the devil will try his level so that you obey, disobey God. Hallelujah. That is the work of the devil. Because the devil doesn't want you to be blessed by God. The devil doesn't want you to be blessed by God. And that's why he will try his level best to see that you disobey God and disobey his commandments. Because when we disobey God's commandment, the Bible says in the book of Jeremiah chapter 11, let us read verse 3. Jeremiah chapter 11 and verse 3. Jeremiah chapter 11 and verse 3.
And said to them, thus says the Lord God of Israel.
Yes.
Cursed is a man who does not obey the words of this covenant.
Hallelujah! Cursed is the man who does not obey the word of this covenant. He didn't say blessed. He said cursed. Cursed is the man who does not obey the word of this covenant. Hallelujah. So when you disobey the word of God, you cannot be blessed. That's where you need to take the word at its face value. Whether you like it or you do not like it. That's where a preacher needs to preach exactly what the word of God says.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So that he, not only he being blessed, that the church also be blessed.
Amen.
That's why when God spoke a blessing for Abraham, he did not say, Abraham, you shall only be blessed. He said, through you, the nation shall be blessed. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because the power was given to a prophet. The power was given to you and to me. See what does it say in the book of Genesis chapter 12 and verse 3. Genesis chapter 12 and verse 3.
I will bless those who bless you.
Yeah.
And I will curse him who curses you.
Hallelujah. Here we see that God has given the command to Abraham. He said that whoever you bless will be blessed and whoever you curse will be cursed. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And that's why we need to understand that we need to honor God.
Amen.
And how can we honor God? By obeying the voice of God.
Amen.
By hearkening to the voice of God.
Amen.
To doing exactly what the Bible says. And that's what we see in Genesis chapter 12 verse 3. God is giving here a word to Abraham. He says that whoever blesses you will be blessed. And whoever curses you will be cursed. And that is very much important. You need to understand. The blessing continues for generation to generation. Hallelujah. That's why when God blessed Abraham, he blessed Isaac and he blessed Jacob. And he blessed the 12 patriarchs. And through Jesus Christ, the blessing of Abraham has been transformed into our lives by Jesus dying on the cross. The Bible says that he became a curse on the cross of Calvary so that the blessing of Abraham may continue on to the Gentiles.
Amen.
Hallelujah. And that's why it is very much important, my brother, my sister, not only that you honor God, but you must also know how to honor your parents. The Bible says that you need to honor your parents so that they may bless you and that you may live in the land for which the Lord has promised. Hallelujah. Because you, one thing you need to understand, God can bless you through your parents. Hallelujah. And that's why we see down the road that when Noah's son Ham, who was also known as Canaan, looked at the nakedness of his father, he did not bother to go and cover his father's nakedness. But instead of a blessing coming upon Cana, you know what happened? He brought a curse upon his life. Hallelujah. Because God has given the power to bless and to curse. So that's why when you honor your parents, when they are at a very old age, that they may bless you before they die. Hallelujah. But here we see, because Ham had disobeyed, he brought a curse upon himself. And the genealogy of Ham, which is also known as Canaan, be cursed. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because God has given us a word. My brother, my sister, it is very much important to look after our parents in a very old age. That instead of cursing their children, that before they die, that they must bless their children. Hallelujah. And that's what is very much important. And that's where for the blessing to take part in our lives, there is a condition. We have to walk righteous in the eyes of God. Hallelujah. Let us quickly turn our Bible to the book of Proverbs chapter 10 and read verse 6. Proverbs chapter 10 and verse 6.
Blessings are on the head of the righteous, but violence covers the mouth of the wicked.
Hallelujah! The Bible says that blessings are on the head of the righteous. That means when you walk righteous before God, no one can stop the blessing upon your life.
Amen.
Now when I say righteousness of God, it's not your own righteousness. Because the Bible says that our righteousness is like 50 rags. It is the righteousness of our Lord and our Savior Jesus Christ that brings our blessings upon our lives. So here it says in Proverbs 10 verse 6 that the blessings are on the head of the righteous. That when you walk righteous before God, no one can stop the blessing. Not even the devil. Hallelujah. That's why when God looked at Job, he said, did you find a righteous man like Job? And because Job was righteous, the Bible says that Job lacked nothing.
Amen.
He lacked nothing. He had children. He had property. He had everything that his hand could possess. Why? Because Job was righteous in the eyes of God. And that's why he was blessed. Do you see clearly? Because God is telling, did you consider my servant Job? Who is righteous in my eyes? Hallelujah. And that's where the Bible says that when you walk righteous before your God, you will receive the blessing of God. Hallelujah. First I have said that you need to be obedient to God to eat the fruit of the land. The second thing I have said that you need to walk in the righteousness of the Lord and the Savior Jesus Christ. Because it's only through the blood of Jesus that you and I are made righteous in the eyes of God.
Amen.
The Bible says in 2 Corinthians chapter 5 and verse 21, he knew no sin but became sin that we may be made righteous through the blood of Jesus Christ. When you're washed with the blood of Jesus Christ, you're made righteous in the eyes of God. And no one can stop the blessing upon your life. Hallelujah. And it's very much important to understand, my brother, my sister. Let us look at the third point. The third point says about the faithfulness of a person. Let us look into the book of Proverbs chapter 28 and let us read verse 20. Proverbs chapter 28 and let's read verse 20.
A faithful man will abide with blessings, but he who hastens to be rich will not go unpunished.
Hallelujah! The Bible says a faithful man will abound in blessing, but he who hastens to become richer will not go unpunished. The Bible clearly says that when you're faithful, blessing will automatically come. Why? Because the God who is so is a faithful God. The Bible says, for he who calls you is faithful and shall do what he has promised in your life. Here the Bible is saying that a faithful man will abound in the blessings of God. You need to remain faithful. And that's what the Bible clearly says. Let us go into 2 Chronicles chapter 26 and verse 5. 2 Chronicles chapter 26 and verse 5.
He sought God in the days of Zechariah.
Yes.
Who had understanding in the visions of God. And as long as he sought the Lord God, made him prosper.
Hallelujah! The Bible clearly speaks of King Uzziah. This King Uzziah sought God faithfully. And as long as he sought God faithfully, the Bible says that he was blessed.
Amen.
He was blessed. But when what you know something happened, that when you're blessed, you must ask God for a humble, broken and a contrite spirit. Because when you're blessed, automatically pride increases in your life. And that's what happened to King Uzziah. That down the road, he went into the tabernacle of meeting and he wanted to offer a not your will to do the work of a priest. Hallelujah. And immediately the Bible says that leprosy broke out of his head and he became a leper all the days of his life. They had to throw him out. He brought a curse. Because in the Old Testament, leprosy means curse, not a blessing. That's why lepers were not allowed to come into the tabernacle of the meeting. And that's why the Bible says that when a leper is healed, he has to go first show himself to the priest. And the priest will examine. And the priest will anoint the leper in three positions. One is the ear, one is the thumb, and one is the right toe. What is the meaning of that? That with your ear, you will be able to listen to the voice of God. With the thumb, it means that with these two hands, you will be able to serve God. And the right toe indicates that with these two legs, that you will be able to walk with God. So when this leper comes and shows himself to the priest, then the priest declares himself to be clean. And then he is allowed into the tabernacles of meeting. So here what happened to King Uzziah? God said, as long as he served, he was blessed. But when pride entered into him, he took the office of a priest. That's why you must be very careful, my brother. Remain in the calling for which God has called you to be. Do not try to take someone else's post. It will not work because God has not called you in that office.
Amen.
So here, King Uzziah was called to be a king, not to be a priest. So what happened? He brought the curse upon himself by disobeying the commandments of God. Because you need to understand the priesthood was given to the tribe of Levi in which God has separated from the 12 tribes of Israel. You see that? Bible says that. And he said, your generation will be continuously as a priesthood. We clearly see that happening, my brother and sister in Christ. And here we see the king who was blessed brought a curse upon himself. That's why it is always important. Remain faithful in the house of God. That's why the Bible gives a powerful testimony of Moses. God is telling to Moses in the book of Hebrews chapter 3. He says that Moses is the most humble and a faithful man in all of my house. It is not the testimony of Moses telling himself that how much he is to God. God is giving a testimony about Moses. Because the testimony of God is greater than the testimony of man.
Amen.
And here God is telling in Hebrews chapter 3 verse 1 and 2. That Moses was faithful in all my house. So faithful was Moses. That even when his sister blamed him and spoke ill of him, he kept his mouth shut. But God did not stop over there. He brought leprosy upon his sister Miriam. We see that. He was such a faithful and such a humble man. He did not open his mouth because he understood that God is the one who judges people. Because the judgment of God is more severe than the judgment of people. You see clearly, when God judges a nation, he destroyed a nation. So when God judges you, your life is finished. But when a person judges you, you may forgive. But when the judgment is given to God, your life is totally destroyed. And here we see clearly that what happened, that Miriam brought leprosy upon herself by speaking against the servant of God, by speaking against the man of God, a man of God who spoke to God face to face, Moses. And here in the book of Hebrews chapter 3 verse 1 and 2, the Bible is saying, God is speaking directly and telling that Moses is the most faithful man in my house. Because when you remain faithful, no one can stop the blessing of God upon you. And that's why it is important that not only you be obedient, not only you walk righteous before God, but you need to remain faithful to see the blessing of God upon you. Because today God has called you to receive the blessing, that you receive the spiritual blessing, and that you receive the physical blessing. Hallelujah! And that's what it is very much important in our lives. To understand the plan and the purpose of God. That's what is very much important for us, my brother. Because the choice is always given to you and it's given to me. To choose good or to choose bad. You see clearly, the choice is always given today. And today, if you want to be blessed spiritually, obey to the voice of God. Listen to the voice of God. Obey His commandment. Walk before God blameless and be righteous in His eyes. And that's what God wanted Abraham to do. If you see in the book of Genesis chapter 17, let us read verse 1. Genesis chapter 17 and verse 1.
When Abraham was 99 years old, the Lord appeared to Abraham and said to him, I am Almighty God. Walk before me and be blameless.
Walk before me and be blameless. God is speaking to Abraham over here. He says, walk before me and be blameless.
Amen.
You see, for Abraham to inherit a blessing, he had to walk before God blamelessly. To receive the blessing. The blessing did not just come automatically to Abraham. For that there were certain rules and conditions which God kept. That's why you need to understand the rules and the conditions which God keeps for a blessing for you to receive. Many people do not receive is because they do not know the rules and the regulations of the word of God. And that's very much important. That's why we do not heed the fruit of the land. Why? That's the way it is. Because one thing I told you in the beginning, that God wants to bless His children, but the devil wants to snatch away the blessing. And that's why when God wanted to bless Israel, the devil used Balaam the prophet. The Bible clearly says that. If you look into Deuteronomy chapter 23 and verse 5, let's read that. What does it say? Deuteronomy chapter 23 and verse 5.
Nevertheless,
The
Lord your God would not listen
to
Balaam. But the Lord your God turned the curse into a blessing of you.
Hallelujah! Your God is telling to Balaam the prophet, the children of Israel are blessed. And who I proclaim blessed is blessed. But here we see down the road that the devil used Balaam the prophet and wanted to curse the children of Israel. At that situation, we see that God entered into the situation and He reversed the curse into a blessing. Hallelujah. You see clearly what I told you before. God wants to bless His children, but the devil wants the curse to come. And that's why the devil will try his level best upon the children of God to disobey God. And that's why in many occasions the devil was successful in making the children of God disobey God. And that's how we put idolatry during the time of Israel. The main weakness of Israel in the Old Testament, that they went and they worshipped idols. Everywhere you see it is recorded from the book of Genesis. If you look in the Old Testament, that whenever God did something, they worshipped God. And when a prophet died, automatically the children of Israel went and worshipped the Baal. They started to worship the Astaroth. They started to worship other gods, in which God has given in His command that you must not bow down or worship either in heaven or earth or under the earth. God has given. And the devil brought idolatry into the heart of Israel. The Bible says in the book of Judges that everyone did according to his own will. You see clearly, that's what happened even to Moses. When Moses went to meet God at Mount Sinai, immediately what happened? For 40 days, a prophet of God was not disobeyed. They thought, oh, maybe he must have died over there. Or maybe some animals have killed him there. And immediately the Bible clearly says that they made a golden calf. And they proclaimed that this golden calf has brought us from the land of Egypt, from the land of slavery. They gave it to idolatry. And that's what is the work of the devil. That's why the devil is always trying to make an idol so that you may worship that idol and that you may bring a curse upon your life. Hallelujah. That's why God said that there shall be no grave image. No grave image must be made. Clearly God has given us instruction. And that's where we see that Israel in the Old Testament brought a curse because of idolatry, because of idol worship. You see, you look at the record. If you look at the record of the northern kingdoms, you will always see that the northern kingdom, which consists of Israel, always they worshippers of idols. We see that. The southern kingdom, certain kings walked with God, and certain kings also went and bowed down before those idols and brought a curse. We see that. And that's what the devil's plan. The devil's plan is to destroy mankind. And how he does it? By by making the children of God disobey God. That's why when you disobey the word of God, it grieved the spirit of God. Hallelujah. And that's why the Bible clearly says that they always rebel against God. They rebel against God. That's why a very powerful word is given in Acts of the Apostles chapter 7 and verse 51. Read that. Acts of the Apostles 7 verse 51.
You stiff-necked,
yes,
and uncircumcised in heart,
mm,
and ears.
Mm.
You always resist the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
As your fathers did, so do you.
Hallelujah! Yes, Stephen is saying, you are same like your father. What they did? You stiff-necked fellows. He's addressing them in that way. You're like your fathers. Your father's genes is inside you, he's telling. You always resisted the Holy Spirit. They rebelled against God. You see, they rebelled against God. And that's what Stephen is addressing here to the Sanhedrin. He's saying, you are just like your father. Just like a father or son, they say. It's the same thing here. He says, you are just like your father. You stiff-necked people who always rebelled against God and grieve the spirit of God. So when you disobey the word of God, when you disobey the commandments of God, you grieve the spirit of God. Hallelujah. And when you rebel against God, you know what happened? God fought against them. Bible says that. Isaiah chapter 63 and verse 10. Read that. Isaiah chapter 63 and verse 10.
But they rebelled and grieved his Holy Spirit. So he turned himself against them as enemies. And he fought against them.
Hallelujah! The Bible says, but they rebelled and grieved his Holy Spirit. So he turned himself against them as an enemy. And he fought against them. You see clearly, it's clearly mentioned in the book of Isaiah 53 verse 10. That they rebelled and they grieved against his Spirit. And what happened there? He fought against them. You see clearly. And that's why, because of disobedience, they brought destruction upon their lives. And today, that's why we see in the life of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ that Jesus was obedient until death on the cross. He was obedient to his Father until death. And because he was obedient, God Almighty exalted the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Above every name. That at the mention of the name of Jesus.
Amen.
That every knee shall bow down and every mouth shall confess.
Amen.
That Jesus alone is God. Amen. Hallelujah. And that's what we imitate Jesus. By walking in obedience. That's why I always pray, Lord, let me be obedient until death. Let me never disobey you at any moment of my life. Because obedience is always better. You see, disobedience is equivalent to witchcraft. The Bible clearly says that. Let us be obedient to what God says. King Saul disobeyed God. He lost his life. He lost his kingdom. He lost his position. Because he disobeyed the commandment of God. And finally, the Holy Spirit also left him. That there was a distressing spirit which entered into the life of King Saul. We see that clearly happening. You see, and finally he was killed. And his family was totally destroyed. Hallelujah! We see that happening. Why? Because of disobedience. And that's why God wants each one of us to obey him at any cost, even of our life, so that we may receive every spiritual blessings which he has in store for us.
Hallelujah.
And that's why today God is speaking to the book of Deuteronomy chapter 11 verse 26 to 28. That this is the command I give before you. That if you obey the voice of God, that you will see every blessing which is written in the word of God. It will come automatically to you. You don't have to search for the blessing. Because the Bible says, says in Proverbs chapter 10 verse 22, the blessing of the Lord makes one rich.
Amen.
And he has no sorrow to bear.
Amen.
When blessing of God comes, there's no more sorrow in your heart. There's only joy.
Amen.
There is only joy.
Amen.
When the blessing of God comes upon your life. But to receive the blessing, you have to be obedient. You have to walk righteous. And you need to remain faithful to receive every blessing that is mentioned in the Word of God.